Welcome, welcome, patrons. Almost a year ago, I made a video about the Grim Anatomy, a strange little set of images found only in the world of Thetis. In that video, I sort of made a call to action for anyone to try and figure out the mystery. And today, I present to you, although not the answer, a really good guess made by Reddit user Rabuon. While this is going to be labeled as a theory video, it's also going to break format a lot, but before all of that, I also want to take the time and address a common comment I get about the Grim Anatomy. So without further ado, the Voynich manuscript. I seem to get this comment every month or so, so please stop commenting, I know, but people have been pointing out that the Grim Anatomy sounds a lot like the Voynich manuscript. For those who don't know what it is, the basics is that it's a large book with various writings and pictures all dating back to the 15th century, but nobody can translate it. Or most of it. Apparently there's a few Latin phrases, but the bulk of it, untranslatable. While there have been many, many attempts to translate the full text, no one seems to do it. They got like World War II codebreakers on this. No one can figure out what it is. So yeah, to the people making the comments that this could be an Easter egg to the Voynich manuscript, I do think there's an element to that, but I just have one major problem with this theory. The Grim Anatomy has been translated. Not by us, or using the images in the book, but by in-game scholars. In the lore, the Grim Anatomy is a book filled with strange drawings that talk about demons, but they know this because they've read it. So while the Grim Anatomy might be inspired by the Voynich manuscript, I doubt they would just hire an artist to make all of this for no reason, or just a simple Easter egg. If this was one image, then yeah, sure, but there's just too many for me to accept that. So maybe I'm holding on to nothing here, but I think that this is something. Anyway, with that out of the way, let's get to the meat of the video. The messages. About 3 months ago, I got the first message from Rabuon, and I've been getting some updates ever since. In total, the messages equal about to 11 pages, so I'm going to try and boil it down as simply as I can. For the most part, everything he said can come down to three main points: the mysterious writing, the unusual images, and his personal theory. The writing. He tried various things to break the code shown in the images. Braille, Morse code, cuneiform, and a few other ciphers. Nothing cracked the case. I tried every cipher that I could find online and tried translating the language and came up with nothing. The best I could get was two words, dog and fruit, next to each other, even though that was probably a fluke. I 100% think that this is completely untranslatable, or if it is, not into English. So I am going to take his word on it. He tried all of that and came up with nothing. I don't think that they would make it this hard just to translate a small Easter egg. So I'm going to assume for now that all that strange writing on the images is just decoration. Now there is a chance, considering that BioWare is based in Canada, that it could be in French Canadian, but I'm inclined to believe that this isn't the case. But even if he wasn't able to decipher the text, Rabuon does make some interesting observations about the writing style. Take this small section of the writing, he points out, and compare it to the Valislin removal mural in Trespasser. The lines and dots do look very similar. Rabuon then theorizes that it could be based on Elvish, although it looks nothing like the Elvish seen in the game, but as he mentions, the people translating this must have a reference to work with so they can translate the little they have. We know that the Valislin was to mark slaves, and it somehow was a bond. As he says, if the ancient elves Valislin had magic that controlled them, then maybe the writing in the Grim Anatomy is some sort of ritualistic magic markings. Throwing in my own hat, the Valislin from the mural looks the most similar to that of Janae's, elven god of crafts. He's also associated with puzzles, and even he himself is a puzzle because we know next to nothing on him. This isn't a lack of lore, but literally in the canon of Thetis, they don't know much about Janae. The images. Because Rabuon debunked that the writing is little more than chicken scratch, he then moved on to what the images shown could be or could mean. And here is the thing with this part. Rabuon found so many possible references to classical works, I think it would be a massive disservice to cut up his work and then deliver it to you in video form. So what we have done is that we made a Google Docs out of the messages he sent me, and I've linked it below. We did edit a bit just to take out the conversational bits between him and I, and just to kind of make it a little bit easier to read. It's still about 9 pages long, but it's a really interesting read, and please, 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 go check it out. In this, it also includes links to the images and references he talks about, so honestly, that Google Doc is going to be a lot more helpful than this video. Please go check out the Google Doc, read what he wrote, have your mind blown. Thank you, have a nice day. But if you don't have time or reading is hard for you, let me sum up the basics here. There is a ton of imagery used in the Grim Anatomy that is strikingly similar to real-world alchemy, astrology, and ancient religions, or what we would call Hermeticism. So the text related to the images talks about the book being about the study of demons and possessions, while the background images themselves seem to be based on transformation, commanding demons, immortality, with splashes of imagery used in association with elven lore and even titans. The theory. So from this, Rabuon has made a few conclusions. In the Google Doc, linked down below, there are more than I'm going to talk about here. I've just picked the one that I think is most likely, and I'm going to talk about that. The Tevinter Scholar. The writer of the Grim Anatomy was a Tevinter scholar that specialized in hermetics, which in the world of Thedas would be the study of alchemy, astrology, and older religions like ancient dwarves and elves. The writer was focused on the anatomy of possession, what changes physically in a person and how it could be the key to elven immortality. They use various possessed and unpossessed animals to try and figure it out, their findings laid out in the pages we see. Eventually, Rabuon theorizes the blight comes into the picture. He believes that it could have been a deal with a demon and that the writer could have seen the inside of the Black City because of the mentions of rot and emptiness. Whatever the writer saw in the Black City or whatever they found out about the blight was so terrible, they attempted to burn their work. Because they were unsuccessful in burning the entire thing, I would even wager that they died doing so. And here's about the time when you expect me to go into holes in the theory, but overall, all I would have to add is that everything is mostly speculations. Because this theory is basically, what if this is all related, the only debunk I have is what if this isn't. What if all the images he found and the similarities is just coincidence? That's all I really have to debunk this. There really isn't that much in the lore that really comes across this or really negates it in any way. So basically everything he found blows my mind a bit because there's no other alternative than this. So if we want to get into the meta of it, it could just be the artist picked out a couple things that looked mystical and threw it on there. That's all I have for debunking, is an artist that was just throwing things in there. And that, your patrons, is it going to be at least my canon for the Grim Anatomy. A huge thank you to user Rabuon, who spent many sleepless nights working on this and did an amazingly thorough job. Rabuon, if you're not a researcher, go into that field, because I think you would be great at it. Reading how much you put into this, I would be honestly shocked if someone can find something else related to this unless you track down the artist and ask them directly. Do you still have lingering questions? Proof that I'm wrong? Comments about your own fan theory? Feel free to tweet me at @gildarthon on Twitter or send a PM to user Gillanon on Reddit. The rest are all.